Toledo.
And our word for today on this Christmas weekday, this Wednesday, December the 3rd, our word for today is children. Children is our word for today. Our reading from the first letter of John chapter 2. If you consider that God is righteous, you also know that everyone who acts in righteousness is begotten by him. See what love the Father has bestowed on us, that we might be called the children of God, and yet so we are. The reason the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now. What we shall be has not yet been revealed. We do know that when it is revealed, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. Everyone who has this hope based on him makes himself pure as he is pure. Everyone who commits sin commits lawlessness, for sin is lawlessness. You know that he was revealed to take away sins, and in him there is no sin. No one who remains in him sins. No one who sins has seen him or known him. Our responsorial psalm, Psalm 98, all the ends of the earth have seen the saving power of God. Sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done wondrous deeds. His right hand has won victory for him, his holy arm. All the ends of the earth have seen the salvation by our God. Sing joyfully to the Lord, all you lands. Break into song, sing praise. Sing praise to the Lord with the harp and melodious song, with trumpets and the sound of the horn. Sing joyfully before the King, the Lord.
Alleluia, alleluia. The Word of God became flesh and dwelt among us. To those who accepted him, he gave power to become the children of God. Our Holy Gospel from John, chapter 1. John the Baptist saw Jesus coming toward him and said, "Behold the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. He is the one of whom I said, 'A man is coming after me who ranks ahead of me, because he existed before me.' I did not know him, but the reason why I came baptizing with water was that he might be made known to Israel." John testified further, saying, "I saw the Spirit come down like a dove from the sky and remain upon him. I did not know him, but the one who sent me to baptize with water told me, 'On whomever you see the Spirit come down and remain, he is the one who will baptize with the Holy Spirit.' Now I have seen and testified that he is the Son of God."
And our word for today, children. Children, our word today, word for today, primarily taken from our first reading, the first letter of John chapter 2, but also from our gospel acclamation today. The Word of God became flesh and dwelt among us. To those who accepted him, he gave power to become children of God. Children of God, and so heirs, the scripture says, of our Father. Again, we go to our first reading from the first letter of John, chapter 2. See what love the Father has bestowed on us, that we might be called the children of God, yet so we are. Yet so we are. You know, we have so many thoughts about who we are, what kind of people we are. We need to remind ourselves who we belong to. And one of the names that belongs to us, one of the titles that belongs to us, I would say the most important title that belongs to us is the one mentioned here. See what love the Father has bestowed on us, that we may be called children of God, yet so we are. And when we claim that title, when we sit under that, when we receive this gift that God has already purchased for us, that we might become his adopted sons and daughters, children of God, heirs of the kingdom of God, then everything that we look at, everything we experience in our lives is measured by that thing. We have to put on that filter that says, I am a child of God. How does this thing affect me as a child of God? How do the things going on in my world, in my life, affect me? And how do I conduct myself knowing that I am a child of God, destined for the kingdom, if I but give myself over to the promise that has been made to me? if I make that a part of everything that I have going on in my life, then things are rightly ordered, priorities are correctly set. If I forget that I am a child of God, everything goes haywire. Because I begin to prioritize things that have nothing to do with me being a child of God. And yet that is what I am. And in the midst of my distress, in the midst of my anxiety, in the midst of my difficulty, I remind myself that I am a child of God. In the midst of my success, in the midst of my joys, in the midst of my celebration, I remind myself that I am a child of God. And everything is pointed toward the heavenly kingdom, toward this reward that is awaiting each of us who have been proclaimed as such, children of God. I, brothers and sisters, you, brother and sister, are a child of God. What else is going on in your life? I don't know. But at the end of the day, that supersedes everything. It's bigger than everything else. And anything that you're encountering, if you can put that in front of it, I am a child of God, even though I am a child of God because I am a child of God despite myself, despite the things that I do, despite the things that are happening in my life, I am still a child of God. And by the way, so are all of the others who are baptized in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, who are members of the body of Christ. They also are children of God. And they need to be looked upon as such in our conversations, in the way that we treat one another, all made in the image and likeness of God, all bearing his likeness. And those of us who have clinged to Christ become children of God through that baptism, becoming part of the body of Christ, then makes us heirs of the kingdom and children of our heavenly Father. See what love the Father has bestowed on us, that we might be called the children of God, yet so we are. The reason the world does not know us is that it did not know him. The reason the world doesn't know us is because the world doesn't know my Father. The world doesn't know my Father. If they knew my Father, they would also be his children. So we ought not be perplexed when the world is in conflict with us. We are members of a different family. We have a different tradition. Right now, the believers and the unbelievers have a different Father. Let's just be clear. And so I have a Father in heaven who loves me and who has called me to himself as he has called every other individual in this world to himself through the death and resurrection of his Son, Jesus Christ. Beloved, we are God's children now. What we shall be has not yet been revealed. We do know that when it is revealed, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. What a glorious title to be called children of God, and then to be reminded in the same reading that awaits us, that what awaits us is even better. It's even better. We do know that when it is revealed, that is, what we shall become is revealed, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. Children, our word for today. Mm-hmm.